All the participants of this workshop. Mr. Chetan, would like to introduce our chairman, Dr. W.G. Prasanna. It's my privilege to introduce the visionary of Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education. I am proud to inform all of the people who are there in the workshop to see that he has served as a public working for the climate change. His expertise in disaster management has him in the advisory panels of several state and national level departments. He is also an expert for the government of Telangana in its disaster response force endeavor, a master trainer for civil services candidates. He conducts intensive training programs periodically at the behest of nationally recognized training institutes. He is currently actively involved in promoting higher education curriculum addressing rural concerns in India. Villagers to be producers, not just consumers. His conviction that drives him to work for rural challenges. He aspires for an adaptive, disaster risk resilient, and eco-responsible India. The curriculum on MBA in waste management and social entrepreneurship and BBA and MBA in rural management are his major academic achievements dedicated to India's rural concerns. This has culminated in several collaboration memorandum of understandings for introduction of MBA, BBA in rural management in higher education institutes across India. So it's my privilege to let you know that our chairman, the visionary Dr. W.G. Prasanna Kumar sir, has been instrumental in developing MGNCRE's state-of-the-art e-learning center with infrastructure for conferencing and training facilities, which include training programs, skill building session, and workshops with facility for video linking the entire country and sharing online educational resources for rural community engagement and development. A man with many firsts to his credits and an incredible record of accomplishments. Dr. W.G. Prasanna Kumar sir is currently guiding Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education in building a resilient rural India. To tell about the educational qualifications, which is never ending, still being a learner has got diversified post graduations. He has a PhD in education with basic degree in social work and master's degree in sociology, public administration, and political science. He also has professional education in environmental economics, public relationship, communications, and training and development. If I keep telling about the edge our visionary chairman has, it's a never-ending process. He is leading Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education from the last 4 years, and we have been very fortunate enough to work with him, work under him, under his guidance. And with his leadership, we have come out with more than 12,600 faculty members in rural entrepreneurship development cells. We have been connected to around 2,100 educational institutes across the country. We have started extending professional help to the needy ones across the country. And to continue further, we are working in capacity building, skill development, and upskilling the faculty members as well as the students of higher education system. I am really proud to introduce our chairman. I invite him, I request him to deliver a talk on today's Viveka Subhashitam on the day of Sri Swami Vivekananda's birthday celebrations. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Chetan. I just wanted to buy some time before others join. And Chetan also supported in. So the intent is not to read out a long biography of a person, but it is basically to help in others who get a little delayed to join in. So a very good afternoon, principals, directors, chairman, faculty members from across the country, and also the students who are linked to us through Facebook and YouTube. It's a fantastic day. It is a day when we are all inspired by Swami Vivekananda in this country. We are very proud to be part of this National Youth Day. Across the country, we participate as youth. We have participated as youth, and we will be participating as youth in various activities, various programs. If you are looking at making this country a great Vishwaguru, a guru who would be Shashvata Vishwaguru, not Vishwaguru on a particular area, on a particular day, on a particular event or particular issue, but a country which can show path to several of the nations across the world, then we are looking at building ourselves with very, very strong roots. So it is in that context that we are all meeting, friends. It's an opportunity to meet you all. Today we will have the opportunity also of listening to AICT chairman and AICT chief coordinating officer, and also a very, very accomplished civil servant, Dr. C. Umamaheshwarrawji. So these people would be also addressing us. So before they come in, I'm basically into setting the stage where all of your institutions which are part of this program have done exceedingly well in your own area. Your institutions have accomplished in a very big way. The contribution which each of you is doing to the knowledge, to the practice of knowledge, and to creation of wisdom in the country has been enormous. And I would congratulate each one of you for having led that great team of young people for over the years. From the time you are part of the institution, from the time you are steering the institution, from the time you have taken on the reins of handling thousands of young people and showing them a way. So thank you very much for being that. This country looks forward to your guidance, your involvement, your support, and your continuous involvement in generating people like you in your area, across the country, and across the world. So friends, lakhs of students go through you. We have more than 48,000 higher education institutions across the country as on date. We from Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education are connected to 1/4 of the higher education institutions in the country through a small mechanism of SL. We are working on three streams. One is rural entrepreneurship development, because country being mostly rural with 60% and above population involved in rural related occupations and professions and allied activities which relating to agriculture. And so it is in this context that we have an area which is rural entrepreneurship development, where the business management institutions across the country offering BBA, Bachelor of Business Administration, and Master of Business Administration are roped in. And across the country, in each of these institutions, just as we have a placement cell, we are also looking at an entrepreneurship development cell. This entrepreneurship development cell is to first introduce young people the opportunities relating to entrepreneurship. It is going to be an institutional mechanism which all of you have taken on. It's fantastic that your institution has taken on this institutional mechanism, which would mean that young people will get continuously support from all of us, from the faculty members. Principals are the leaders. The total education system looks at your leadership, the registrars, the vice chancellors, directors, and the heads of institutions. You make a huge contribution to this country. So in the same fashion, you are also going to contribute to the entrepreneurship developments in the country. Hum dusron ko naukri denge aur itna hum majboot banenge ki we make several opportunities possible for several people. all of us are aware of self-help groups. So this is a self-help group of young students who are part of educational institutions. These young students who are part of educational institutions are also going to start thrift, just as women have contributed by 1 rupee thrift or 2 rupees thrift every day and have developed the capital. And across the country, we have lakhs of women groups who are involved in economic activities. We are looking at lakhs of student groups across the country who are involved in economic activity. Activity chota ho ya bada ho, koi short term ho ya long term ho, bada capital ho ya chota capital ho, vistar desh bhar ka kaam ho ya it is a small activity linked to your own institution or one class of students. But that activity is being promoted through you. You are fantastic people. You are the leaders in this. If the principal, as and when the principal takes the role of being a leader in entrepreneurship development cell, the entrepreneurship will become the culture of the educational institution. That is what we are looking at, friends. Another area which we are also looking at is vocational education, Nayi Taleem, and experiential learning. Gandhiji had this great dream. We have just completed 150th birth anniversary of Gandhiji. Gandhiji's great dream was to make this country self-reliant. Abhi hum log jo baat kar rahe hain atmanirbharta ka, that was the dream. Ye kaisa hasil karna hai? What is the way out for this? Use the hands, head and heart together in unison. यही बात स्वामी विवेकानंद ने भी बोला है कि हाथ और मस्तिष्क और दिल तीनों भी साथ में चले, सो दैट वी हैव एकाग्रता फ्रॉम दी ब्रेन फ्रॉम दी हेड एंड दी कुशलता फ्रॉम दी हैंड्स एंड दी लव एंड अफेक्शन फॉर व्हाट एवर वी आर डूइंग फ्रॉम द हार्ट. सो विथ निष्ठा विथ कंटिन्यूअस कन्विक्शन when we are working, we can make huge difference. ये बात गांधी जी ने कहा है. उसको उन्होंने, गांधी जी ने उनको वो काम को का नाम दिया है नई तालीम. So नई तालीम is a method by which head, hand and heart work in unison, where the students learn different subjects through activities and programs and works, so that वो काम में जो science है वो science सीखेंगे, वो काम में whatever mathematics is there in that work, they learn the mathematics, they will learn the social studies, kahan se wo utpadan hua hai, kahan se wo saman aaya hai, kahan par jayega, economic geography and the physical geography the young child will learn when he is handling material. Hands are put into action and with lot of involvement of the head and heart, the students' learning happens. The integration of various disciplines happens. Kheti baadi mein kaam kare ya koi kaamkaaj mein hai lage lage, ya vegetables growing mein rahe ya vegetables consumption mein bhi lage, kitna hum vegetable leke aaye, how much vegetable consumption is there on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, on a monthly basis, how is the budget changing. These are the ways by which the child gets into practice of mathematics. हमारा मैथमेटिक्स ऐसा बताता कि इफ ए चाइल्ड कैन रन 100 मीटर्स इन 10 सेकेंड्स, इफ यू गो बाय मैथमेटिक्स 1000 मीटर्स, हाउ मेनी सेकेंड्स विल द चाइल्ड बी एबल टू रन. इफ दैट इज व्हाट वी आर अप्लाइंग, देन 10 इनटू 10 इज 100 सेकेंड्स द चाइल्ड शुड बी एबल टू रन 1000 मीटर्स. लेकिन रियलिटी में ऐसा नहीं होता है. 1000 मीटर्स रनिंग का एक स्पीड होता है, 100 मीटर्स रनिंग का एक स्पीड होता है, 200 मीटर्स रनिंग का एक स्पीड होता है. द मोमेंटम इज डिफरेंट. सो टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द मैथ एंड द रियलिटी, द स्टूडेंट इज कंटिन्यूअसली इन्वॉल्व्ड इन प्रैक्टिस ऑफ मैथ्स देन लर्निंग ऑफ मैथ्स. ये पूरे चीज हम इसको पूरा डिस्क्राइब करना है. दैट इज द लैंग्वेज दैट द स्टूडेंट नीड्स एंड यूजेस फॉर टेकिंग द आइडियाज फॉरवर्ड. सो दिस इज द रूट फॉर वोकेशनल एजुकेशन, नई तालीम, एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग. अनुभवजन्य शिक्षा से, विद एक्सपीरियंस व्हेन वन लर्न्स, देन दैट लर्निंग स्टैंड्स फॉरएवर. इसलिए हम बीएड कॉलेजेस में, डीएड कॉलेजेस में, शिक्षा संस्थानों में वी आर ट्राइंग टू प्रमोट द वोकेशनल एजुकेशन सेल्स. आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू शेयर विथ यू that across the country, we have more than 4,500 vocational education cells in the vocational in the teacher educational institutions. Har jagah par kaam chal raha hai. And fortunately for us, the National Education Policy 2020 is also focusing on vocational education. So it is exactly in unison with the national policy and the national requirement that we are working. The third area that we are looking at is social entrepreneurship. Jo entrepreneurship udyamikta ka jo bare mein hum sochte hai, entrepreneurship is not restricted to commercial enterprise. Entrepreneurship is not restricted to business management institutions or business management education. Entrepreneurship could be done by any student of any stream of education. कोई भी काम करना है उसके जिंदगी में तो कुछ कमाना है कुछ करना है उसके लिए ध्यान लगाकर काम continuously काम करना है. So for that to happen, we require the support of people working in every sector. Any employee today who is successful. He is successful not because of the rules and regulations, not because of the duties and responsibilities, not because of the job description, but because the employee takes ownership, employee takes pride in doing something, employee takes risks, employee goes beyond the calling, employee works beyond the hours, and employee works on achieving something. He has his or her own benchmarks. That benchmark determines where he is going. So it is in this context that we are looking at entrepreneurship in the social domain also. Even rainwater harvesting is an entrepreneurship area. Even handling of vegetables is an entrepreneurship domain. Even working on solar panels is entrepreneurship domain. So if we are looking at an educational institution, some educational institution mein aaj ke din mein 5 टीम्स बनाने की बात करते हैं. झाड़ पेड़ पौधे को देखभाल करना, प्लांटेशन, ट्री मेंटेनेंस, ट्री अपकीप इज वन एरिया, सो दैट यू आर डिसाइडिंग विच स्पीशीज इन विच एरिया एंड हाउ टू हैंडल देम. अनदर एरिया इज वाटर कंजर्वेशन, हाउ टू हैंडल द वाटर, रूफ टॉप वाटर, अवेलेबल वाटर, क्रिएट अ वाटर बजट फॉर द कैंपस, क्रिएट अ वाटर सेंसिटिव पीपल and water efficient community in the campus and among the students. Each of these activity has a work element and hence has an entrepreneurship element. That is one area which we can contribute to and work in. Just as my colleagues have already informed or have already been discussing, all of you have been working on this. We have been working on composting or waste management, including paper waste management, including e-waste management. Hamare paas jahan kahan bhi hamare paas aaj ke din mein electrical and electronics material hai, mein computers hai, har jagah par we have today e-waste generated. 4 saal 3 saal ke baad mein har jagah par after the usage of material there is a scrap being produced. That scrap 50% 60% of that scrap is reusable. If we don't put into reuse, it becomes junk and it becomes a hazard for the communities. So e-waste management, that is an entrepreneurship opportunity. Composting is an entrepreneurship activity. Handling of the plastic waste is an entrepreneurship activity. Laboratory waste, glass waste, each of them is a stream of earning. So that being promoted through the social entrepreneurship cell, we have more than 4,600 social entrepreneurship cells being constituted across the country. हम लोग स्वच्छ भारत अभियान में, स्वच्छता एक्शन प्लान में, हर कॉलेज में, हर इंस्टीट्यूशन में स्वच्छता में हमको क्या करना है, उसको क्या सिद्ध करना है, उसका एक मेथोडोलॉजी और एक इंडिकेटर लिस्ट बनाए, जिसको आज के दिन में AICTE UGC इस्तेमाल करके दे, यूटिलाइज दिस मेथोडोलॉजी, दिस इंडिकेटर्स लिस्ट फॉर इवेल्युएटिंग द इंस्टीट्यूशंस. नाउ each of the institution across the country is being evaluated or being graded on swachhata. Even in the other rankings, whether it is the national rankings in terms of the faculty or in terms of the institutions, we have this opportunity of ranking and working on the ranks which are relating to our green component, green works. So ग्रीन में आज के दिन में हम वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट भी लेके आते हैं और ग्रीनरी भी लेके आते हैं, प्लांटेशन के साथ में वाटर मैनेजमेंट भी लेके आते हैं. लास्ट एस्पेक्ट विच इज वेरी वेरी क्रिटिकल इज गेटिंग इनटू ग्रीन एनर्जी, एनर्जी विच इज लिंक टू द सोलर एरिया. सोलर एरिया में हमको बहुत काम करना है. ऑलरेडी लॉट ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस, मेनी ऑफ यू हैव इंस्टॉल्ड सोलर पैनल्स एंड मेनी ऑफ यू आर वर्किंग ऑन सोलर पैनल्स. सोलर पैनल इज एन एंटरप्राइज बाय इटसेल्फ. लेइंग सोलर पैनल्स इज एन एंटरप्राइज बाय इटसेल्फ. मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द सोलर पैनल्स इज एन एंटरप्राइज बाय इटसेल्फ. जस्ट एज कंपोस्ट, कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ए कंपोस्ट स्ट्रक्चर इज एन एंटरप्राइज. हैंडलिंग ऑफ कंपोस्ट इज एन एंटरप्राइज. Selling of compost is an enterprise. Each of the activity can be handled as an enterprise. Water harvesting is an enterprise. Maintenance of the water harvesting structure is an enterprise. Maintenance of the pipelines which are leading to water harvesting structures across our huge campuses is also an enterprise. And maintenance of the contour trenches across the borders of our college so that the water from the campus will not go out and will remain in the campus and will support annually maintaining them also is an enterprise. Looking at each of them as an enterprise is what we are trying to consider and we are trying to work on. इसलिए बहुत सारे institutions, more than 4,600 institutions में आज के दिन में social entrepreneurship, स्वच्छता और community rural engagement ये काम का एक cell बनाए. तो these cells are institutional mechanisms. And the principles make huge difference. As principles, when you are involved in social entrepreneurship promotion or entrepreneurship promotion, ya aap rural entrepreneurship area mein kaam kare, ya vocational education mein kaam kare, hum sab ye sab ka kaam ka ek hi natija hai. The only direction in which all of us are going is hum mangenge nahi, hum dene layak banenge. We will become competent to handle. There are several of gaps in the world. In our own country, there are several gaps. In every area, gaps. Each of the gap provides an opportunity, and opportunity has an associated risk. We build a country which has risk-taking capacity. Young people who are risk-taking in their nature. Young people who are competent to handle any risk at any point of time. That is what is our goal. In this endeavor, being principals, you have a huge responsibility which you have already been taking on and very effectively implementing. You have made a name for yourself. All those great institutions which are part of today's interaction, you have made extraordinary contribution to your area. You have been a wonderful group of people. Your area not only has been benefited, but your people, your young students from your institutions have grown across the world. Their contribution has been enormous. As a faculty member, when you were promoting your institution as a faculty member, later on now as a principal, and some of you who are started as initiator of an institution, your contribution has been phenomenal and it has been extraordinary in terms of helping the human resource in this country. And now we are looking at each of the educational institutions which is part of this great endeavor, great effort, being committed and being committed to every student being Atmanirbhar, every student not asking for but providing for, looking for opportunities, whether it is a technology area, whether it is a social area, whether it is in handling the communities, the students have a great role and they're all being shaped in our educational institutions. We can make huge dent, huge impact on the world around. You have been doing it and we are looking at an institutional infrastructure for that. Your students generating their own capital, saving their capital, forming a self-help group through the cell. This self-help group providing finance for their small little activities relating to entrepreneurship. Chota chota kaam karte hue bade kaam mein hum jod sakte hain. Starting from selling the rangoli for Sankranti to selling the colors for Holi, being part of any festival, religious festival or any festival or any function, supporting with it for a small pecuniary gain, and also with a social commitment, we can make huge impact. So it is in this context that we are all meeting, friends. We'll have very soon the chairman of AICTE with us, and his take on entrepreneurship we will listen to. AICTE has also been promoting entrepreneurship for several years now. We thought we would extend it to all other non-technical institutions also. Definitely every management institution should also have an entrepreneurship development cell, just as every other discipline institution should have a social entrepreneurship development cell. And all institutions should have their commitment to greening of the campuses, greening of the communities around, and greening of the country. So it is in this context that we are all working on. Now with vocationalization being made part of education at every level, starting from the school to the higher education, our contribution will be phenomenal, because we have to get several of the people from the society, accomplished people from the society in the neighborhood and across the country, to come to the college, come to the campus, wo adjunct faculty banenge, hamare students se interact karenge. They will initiate several things. They will create that momentum which is required. So the society is going to get into the campus and help the campus in a way that the student's responsibility is also shared by the community. There is service learning which the students will get into during their summer internship, summer time or winter time. So we are looking at three shifts. One shift is internship while the student is in the course. Second shift is apprenticeship. Immediately after the course, he is part of one enterprise, one activity, one social activity, or one functional activity in the neighborhood. That is apprenticeship. Then we are looking at the final shift, which is the entrepreneurship. So entrepreneurship will have two steps before. One is the apprenticeship immediately after the course, and the ship before the apprenticeship is the internship. So we are looking at summer internships, winter internships, helping the students in learning the life skills and also contributing to themselves and to the nation. So this is an opportunity which all of us have as the leaders of educational institutions, and I take this as a great opportunity to interact with you and to learn from you and to share some of my thoughts. Thank you very much for taking your time and for being here on this occasion, and your involvement and your presence makes huge difference. I'm very glad to share with you that Professor Anil Sahasrabuddhe ji, Chairman AICTE, has joined the meeting on dot. So the program will continue on dot, will move as per the timing we have, and the final speaker of the day will be Professor Uma Maheshwar Rao, who will be Dr. Uma Maheshwar Rao, who's been an IAS officer, who's retired from the government civil service, who's now contributing to education system across the country, involved in several of the activities. He will join from US. So friends, I will Mr. Sudhir, please take it forward. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. We welcome Professor Anil Sahasrabuddhe, sir, and also Dr. Umaishwar, sir, also joined this program. Welcome you, sir. Welcome to this program. And I also request Dr. Vivek, sir, from Sanskriti Foundation. Dr. Vivek, sir. Manoj, sir, please also unmute Vivek, sir, and make him co-host. So we are very glad to have Honorable Chairman of AICTE, Anil Sahasrabidya sir, as the chairman sir told on time. We are very glad to see you, sir. So we'll start the main proceedings of this program as Viveka Subhashitam, which is one of the Do Good, Be Good campaign, which we are going ahead. Yes, we can see Dr. Chamathi Omeshwar, sir. Thank you, sir, for joining here from MGNCRA team. Manoj, sir, please make Vivek, sir, as co-host.
No, he has unmuted me now.
Yes, welcome, Dr. Vivek, sir. Thank you so much for being part of this program. And we hand over the proceedings to you to take it forward in a great way. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Sudhir ji. Namaskar to all of you. To be good and to do good, that is the whole of religion, said Swami Vivekananda. I am Dr. Vivek Modi. I welcome all of you on behalf of Samskriti Foundation and Team Mahatma Gandhi Council of Rural Education. A hearty thanks to all of you from the senior functionaries from the different parts of India. We can see a mini India here right now in our Zoom meeting. So many of you have joined us. Thank you so much. A warm welcome. My heartiest welcome to our chief guest, Professor Anil Sahasrabuddhe sir, Honorable Chairman of All India Council for Technical Education. Thank you so much, sir, for your presence. We are really honored to have you here. I welcome our Markdarshak, Dr. C.H. Uma Maheshwar Rao, sir, Chamartu Uma Maheshwar Rao, sir ji. Sir, thank you so much for joining us. And this may be an odd timing for you being in US there. Thank you so much for your presence, and it really encourages us. A hearty welcome to all other delegates. We wait for Dr. Butha Chandrasekhar ji as he joined. We'll welcome him as well. Now, here I conclude my welcome address and I hand it over to Dr. Prasanna Kumar ji to talk about our partnership with MGNCRE. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much, Vivek ji, for introducing the guests of the evening. We have so many people from across the country, starting from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari. We have people from Kutch to from Andaman Nicobar also in this team. We have more than 590 principals from various educational institutions, directors, chairmen of these educational institutions. I have been inspired by these two guests who are here today. My first inspiration is, of course, Dr. C. Uma Maheshwar Rao ji, who is on our board, governing body, and who is also a finance committee member for us, and who incidentally is also chairman for Samskriti Foundation. Another great inspiration is Anil Sahasrabuddhe ji, Professor Anil Sahasrabuddhe ji. Whenever I went to him, he is very warm, he is very nice, and he is an inspiration wherever he goes. And several of the technical educational institutions across the country have been blessed with his guidance and support. In fact, AICT under his leadership has also asked us to develop the curriculum on rural management. So we have been part of the committee for developing the rural management curriculum at bachelor's and master's level. And this curriculum was unveiled by the Ministry of Environment at that time, Ministry of Education, at that time, Ministry of Human Resource Development. I would like to share with the August gathering here the backdrop of this work. We have also been inspired by an event which is started by Samskriti Foundation 4-5 years back, when they have taken on Swami Vivekananda's campaign of Do Good and Be Good. So this is an opportunity to do good and be good between Swami Vivekananda's birthday and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose's birthday. So Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose's birthday falls on 23rd of January, and Swami Vivekananda's birthday falls on 12th of January, that is today. So it is this period between these two dates that we thought is the right time to promote NAIC activity, good activity, great activity across the country. So entrepreneurship we consider as one of the big activity, great activity, which can be done, which can push the students into thinking in terms of where is the gap in the country? How will we fill that gap in the country, whether it in the social sector or business sector or economic sector, and how that can also be an opportunity for livelihood and for a future. So considering those aspects, we have partnered, Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education has partnered with the knowledge partner, that is Samskriti Foundation. In fact, for my work for the Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education's work in entrepreneurship development, AICT is the inspiration. AICT has started entrepreneurship development, and wherever Professor Anil Sahasrabuddhi ji went, he promoted this component of students being on their own, student being a contributor. And in fact, the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, with the support of AICT, has taken many strides only because of the presence of the technical support of AICT. And this is an opportunity for our tiny institution to come together with the great institution, giant institution, which is AICT. We would like to benefit from learnings that have been accrued over a period of time by the contribution that has been made by AICT to this country in the technical education, in management education. Phenomenal contribution has been made, not only in terms of regulating, but also in terms of promoting.